see what they have to say.
The franchise that's been rebooted more times than Lieutenant Dangle has returned.
Oh!
And after making a killing in theaters, one thing is for sure. People would rather get COVID than sign up for Peacock. Halloween Kills. You've grown as the Strodes faced off against Michael Myers. Now, get ready to see what literally everyone else in town was up to that night. From Dr. Loomis's nurse, to the kid Lori used to babysit, to the kid Lori's friend used to babysit, to the kid that used to bully the kid that Lori used to babysit. All of Haddonfield will band together to reminisce about that 5 minutes of screen time they got 40 years ago.
40 years ago, a madman escaped from a mental hospital.
He killed my daughter 40 years ago.
He's infected my family with grief and fear for 40 years.
Michael Myers has haunted this town for 40 years.
40 years ago, when I was a kid, you protected me.
Michael Myers has returned. Extra crispy. He'll pick up right where he left off, mindlessly killing people. Then very mindfully arranging their bodies in an artful tableau. It's missing a certain je ne sais quoi. Perhaps one more knife. Right there. And the only thing standing in his path is franchise stalwart Laurie Strode. No? She might as well be in a coma.
Yeah.
Okay. Standing in the way of Mike is Allison Strode, the next in line to take over the franchise. No?
Yeah.
She immediately proves she isn't worthy.
There we go. Thank you.
Okay.
Immediately
standing
proves.
In the way of Mike is Karen Strode, who finally realized her mom was right and became the badass she was raised to become. No? She's still trying to calm things down?
What are you doing? Karen,
no.
Out of my mind.
No?
Wow, okay. Standing in the way of Mike are two gay pirates and an elderly couple with a drone. Cool. Because this was clearly the middle part of a trilogy, and this killer is craving some filler for Halloween.
Do you know what That's happens right. to people who come into the Myers home without an invitation?
We're not even scared.
He stabbed his sister in the
You were impressed slash confused to learn
that?
Danny McBride helped write these reboots.
Yeah.
But it takes someone like Kenny Powers to write characters this stupid. As all of Haddonfield fights back on Halloween night in the dumbest ways possible.
Yes, thank you.
Whether they're splitting into smaller and smaller groups.
Lindsay,
stay here.
Okay, so the key is we stick together.
Now I'm going in alone.
What?
Falling for the same tricks they did 40 years ago.
Oh, jeez.
Mistaking a Danny DeVito lookalike for Michael Myers.
Thank you.
Even though they all grew up with him and his face is on the news.
It's not him.
And showing up to a climactic beatdown in their PJs. Look, that guy brought a hockey stick. Who plays cricket in Haddonfield, Illinois? That girl brought a clothes iron. Where are all of your guns? I thought this was America. And you're just gonna leave him there? Chop him up into pieces or blow the body up like a beach whale?
Nope.
He's just gonna get up again.
There we
See?
Go.
What did I just say? How drunk are you people?
What did
Prepare
I just
yourself
say?
For a film with a message. Are remorseless serial killers what we should be worried about? Or is forming a mob to stop them the real evil? And, like the former, duh. Moving on. So enjoy a muddled new installment that tries to strike
Oof,
a balance
I hated that
between
one.
The old school scares of the slasher genre, the self-aware comedy of the current era.
Michael Myers is in a backseat. Go look.
Go look. Go look. Hell no.
A little bit of John Wick. And social commentary usually reserved for Jordan Peele or an A24 film about a goat that stands for a miscarriage or whatever. It may not be perfect, but it's still a perfect example of a nostalgia-fueled sequel to a reboot made to erase bad sequels that itself is a reboot of the sequels it got rebooted to erase in the first place. And my nose is bleeding again. Great. Starring The Shove.
A lot of that.
Strode Rage.
Strode
Rage. Karen. Allie McSqueal. I did my own research. Lonnie Jenkins.
Now I'm going in alone.
Officer involved rebooting. The Real Housewives of Haddonfield.
Still
The Speed School of Hostage Negotiation. Better Cameo Saul. And Paula Wieners. This is 40 years ago when Michael Myers killed my family. The actual coolest part of this movie? Realistic Donald Pleasance prosthetics. Wow.
Thank you.
Say that 3 times fast. Donald Pleasance prosthetics. Donald Pleasance prosthetics. Donald Pleasance prosthetics.
That was a good honest trailer. I like how he speaks to how we, like, certain characters should be the new Laurie Strode in this one, and no one really is. It's just Michael Myers' movie. That's pretty much what it is. And it's really just a filler film. It has nothing it wants to say, really new or exciting or creative, that it wants to say within the story. If you haven't seen my review of the film, check that up right here, because I go into more detail about some of that. But it's there. The kills are fun, so that makes it fun, but it's just there. It does make you want the third one, because you're like, there is a way they have to end this thing. Like, it can't just keep going like it used to with the old ones. But we have to wait a little bit, so we'll see how it ends. Before we get to the pitch meeting, I want to give a huge shout out to all my members and my subscribers. Thank you guys so much for supporting the channel in any way that you do. Big shout out to my Hypercrew members, Brian Tidwell, Steve O, Slepnir, Dash Milner, K6013, Daniel Lopez, Portal on Mobile 44, Jonathan Cederland, Kratos, and William Cooper. Thank you guys for supporting the channel with that top tier crew. I really appreciate you. Now, let's get to the pitch meeting.
You have a Halloween sequel for me?
Yes, sir,
sequel,
I do.
Sequel. So you remember in the last movie how Laurie Strode shot two of Michael Myers' fingers off and stabbed him and left him for dead in a house fire?
I do, yeah.
So at the beginning of this movie, Laurie's gonna see some firefighters on their way to the fire and be like, oh, dang it, no.
She didn't account for the existence of firefighters when she planned a house fire?
She didn't, no. So then Michael's gonna kill like 10 firefighters.
A bunch of firefighters in great physical condition get taken out by an 8-fingered 60-year-old with smoke inhalation.
That's what we're going with. Because first of all, they each take turns attacking
That's
him.
Right.
And second of all, Michael's now surprisingly good at martial arts.
Oh, maybe it's one of those house fires you keep hearing about that are very, you know, educational karate-wise. I might have just made that up.
Maybe. So then at the hospital, Laurie has emergency surgery because Michael had stabbed her as well.
Oh, that's right.
And then you're going to like this. She's going to spend the rest of the movie in a hospital
That's right.
bed, barely having anything to do with anything.
Aren't we billing Jamie Lee Curtis as the star of this movie? Feels like she should do something.
Well, actually, at a certain point, she is gonna get out of bed, but then she's gonna be like, ouch, my stitches, and she's gonna go back
ouch.
To bed.
That works.
So then we're gonna go to a local bar and meet some characters that are having, like, a Halloween talent show. Now, this is still the same night as the last movie, isn't it? Yeah, it's about an 18-hour night, I'd say. So this guy, Tommy Doyle, gets on stage, and he's actually the kid that Laurie was babysitting in the 1978 movie.
So what's his talent? Ruining everybody's fun.
Oh, it is. Yeah, he goes on stage, and he's like, I'm not doing any talent thing. I just want to remind everyone that there were murders that happened 40 years ago.
Oh yeah, that guy's a real buzzkill.
He is. And then on the bar TV, they're gonna see that Michael Myers and this other guy escape from a psychiatric hospital.
Oh, so they see his face?
They do, yeah. We don't see it because it's blurred to us, but they do.
Oh.
So Tommy That's Doyle right. decides he's gonna get a mob together and go kill Michael.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, he says Michael's been terrorizing this town for 40 years, so evil dies tonight.
Hasn't Michael been locked up for 40 years after killing 3 people in the late 70s?
Yeah, just terrorizing the town. So Tommy's like, evil dies tonight.
Yeah, he already said that.
Oh yeah, no, I know. About half the lines in here are people saying evil dies tonight.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Right. So Tommy goes around recruiting people for his mob, and he's like, we're gonna go murder a guy. Do you want to come with? And people are like, yeah, okay.
Oh, being easily convinced to do murder is tight.
It is. So all these people, they're gonna be like, evil dies tonight.
Right.
So Tommy gets pretty much the whole town together because he's like, there's strength in numbers.
Smart.
So now that they have the numbers, they all split up into little easy to kill groups.
Smart.
And at the hospital, Laurie's granddaughter Allison is like, I'm going to go join a mob and find Michael and kill him because evil dies tonight.
Okay.
But her mom Karen is like, no, Allison, Michael's definitely on his way to the hospital to kill Laurie. So for you to be safe, you should stay in the hospital.
Oh, that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I'm just kind of filling time between kills. I'm hoping nobody pays attention to this stuff.
Yeah, fingers crossed.
So then for most of the movie, we're gonna kind of meet characters for a little bit, and then they're gonna die horrible deaths.
Yep.
Wait, so who's the protagonist in this thing?
Pass.
That's fine. And then eventually the mob finds out that one of the escape patients is in the hospital, so they're like, oh my, that's gotta be Michael. We gotta kill him.
Is it Michael?
No, it's not. It's this short little balding guy running around screaming, help me, please help me.
So they realize that's not the 7-foot-tall man whose face they just saw on TV.
They're still pretty convinced it's him. So the mob chases this guy down, and he gets so scared he jumps off the hospital and dies.
Oh, my God.
And so meanwhile, the real Michael Myers goes back to his childhood home, and there's this couple living there, Big John and Little John.
Uh-oh.
So one of them sees a bloody handprint on the wall next to their open back door, so they're like, oh, my God, somebody's in the house.
So they call the cops?
Well, no, they close the door and split up and start checking rooms separately. Also a decent strategy. Yeah, you'd think that would work, decent. But it doesn't, and they both die.
Oh.
And then this guy Lonnie and his son and also Allison, they figure out that this is where Michael went, so they head over there.
They don't alert the rest of the mob or the police.
Nope, they head over alone.
Nothing wrong with that.
So then they get there, and Lonnie's like, you two need to stay safe, so I'm gonna go in alone.
Smart as well, sure.
So he goes into the house and immediately screams, so his son and Allison, they go in as well.
Oh, immediately disregarding the strategy.
That's the idea. So then Michael kills the guy.
Well, there was no way to see that coming.
Agreed. And then he's about to kill Allison, but Karen pops out and stabs him in the back with a pitchfork and stomps on his head while he's down.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's badass.
So does she stab him another couple times, make sure he's dead?
No, 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 no. She walks out onto the street and she's like, hey, Michael, if you want to kill someone tonight, kill me. But she has him stabbed and on the floor.
Yeah,
so she uses that opportunity to lure him outside.
Well, okay then.
So then he gets up and follows her outside, and the whole mob is waiting for him.
Oh.
And the mob is like, evil dies tonight.
That does sound like them.
And they're all geared up with weapons.
What kind of weapons are we talking?
We're talking hockey stick, baseball bat, couple knives, brass knuckles.
Nope, don't people have guns?
Well, a couple, but not really, you know. This is small town America. They don't really have guns. Anyway, so now it's Michael versus a big mob of people.
Oh man, it's gonna be impossible for him to beat those numbers. Actually, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Very much so.
Oh, really? Yeah, see, they shoot and stab him in a couple of non-lethal areas, and then they're like, hey, we did it, gang. He's dead for sure.
Nobody goes for a headshot?
They don't, no. So then Michael gets up.
How, though? I mean, even with crappy weapons, they should have enough people to take him down.
Well, see, they do like the firefighters, and they attack one at a time, and those who do have guns try to fire them within grabbing range.
No, these people are terrible at staying alive.
They are. Grabbing so then Karen range. Goes inside Michael's house and looks out the window, and then he pops out and kills her.
Aren't there any police around?
Oh, yeah, there's a ton of cops, but Michael sneaks around them off screen, which means I don't need to explain how that happened. Oh, is that how writing works? It is.
Neat.
And then we're also going to say that with every kill, Michael gets more powerful. So he's like supernatural? Maybe. I don't know. Okay. Oh, and also we're going to say that Michael never actually cared about Laurie Strode. He just wanted to go home.
Oh. All right.
So then in the next movie, Halloween Ends, we're going to have the big showdown between Laurie and Michael.
And you just said he doesn't really give a crap about her at all?
That's right.
So that's the stage you've set for yourself.
Exactly. We're going to keep it focused on that epic showdown in which one of the parties doesn't really care.
Sure, you got to keep it focused.
Yeah. But then also just kind of throw a bunch of other gimmicks in there too, I think.
Well, sure.
I don't think you guys understand how happy I am that Ryan talks about the evil dies tonight chant that the whole crowd was doing. Because it was ridiculous. It felt so off and weird and cringy. And they keep doing it throughout the movie, just randomly. Like one person, a couple people, the whole crowd. It's just so cringy. It's like, okay, this isn't really working. But this was hilarious. Honest Trailers and Pitch Meeting Go had a lot of the same things about how, hey, let's form a group of people to go after Michael Myers. Let's then split up those groups into smaller, more killable groups, easily killable groups, to try to take him down. It doesn't work. Even the large group at the end, it just doesn't work. They try, they think he's dead, even though they did just a few more things and some other people did in this movie with like stabbing him or hitting him over the head. Nothing much more than that. And then he goes on another killing spree. The movie's just a killing spree of him going around just murdering people. Once the group comes around, it's like, oh, hey guys, thanks. You easily came within arm's length of me so I can slash you all and kill everyone. And he just goes crazy at the end. It's filmed very weirdly though. Like I didn't like how they filmed the end with that, because it's just like, okay, this is weird. It's during a little monologue from Laurie Strode talking about how he may be supernatural, possibly. But yeah, it's not done very well. But he goes on a big killing spree here. Can we also talk about this whole thing going on that Michael Myers is homophobic because he killed that gay couple? First off, he's an equal opportunity killer, okay? He kills everyone. Black, white, gay, straight, it doesn't matter. He's going to murder you. He doesn't care. It's just annoying sometimes. Just a few thoughts on that. Just a heads up though, I have seen the first movie. I've seen Halloween 2018, and I like it better than this one. The Halloween Kills. I like it better than this one. The story is so much better. It feels like a different movie. The tone of this one is, to me, was very different from the first one. So just my two cents. So be on the lookout for that as far as the Pitch Meeting Honest trailer reaction for those and maybe one other surprise. Let me know your thoughts on the Honest trailer and the pitch meeting for Halloween Kills. Have you seen it? What'd you think of the movie? What'd you think of these two videos, the Honest trailer, the pitch meeting? Which one do you think was better between the two? I'm glad they put them out together, so I was able to just do this, mash them up pretty quickly here. So I think that was pretty fun. If you're still here, hit that like button if you haven't done so already. It really helps out the channel in a big way. Another thing that helps out the channel is hitting that subscribe button. That goes a long way. We just hit 7,000, a little over 7,000 now, but it's all because of you guys. So I really appreciate you. But if you're watching and you're not subscribed, go ahead, hit that subscribe button. You won't miss out on any more videos. You have some fun here. You can also check out our most popular videos on the channel and our most recent reaction as well. Or you can also check out some of the channels I put in the description. They got some really great content and I think you'll enjoy it. If you've seen all of that, I'll see you guys in the comments. We can talk more about these Halloween Kills videos. Very funny videos. Otherwise, have yourselves a great rest of your day and I'll see you guys on the next one.